Disco is a VUV beamline, 1 to 10 EV, with a particular care on the conservation of the natural polarization of the synchrotron line. Disco is dedicated to biochemistry and biology, and is also part of the health and well-being scientific section of Synchrotron Soleil. After 12 years of operation, Disco is proud to host a broad spectrum of scientific communities, from cell biology, biomedicine, biochemistry, chemistry, up to ancient materials and geology. The unique setup of Disco Beamline allows to follow dynamic processes such as antibiotic resistance, biosource materials, viral infection, and epigenetic processes. Disco Beamline offers two experimental end stations. First, a synchrotron radiation circular diacritic end station, which opens up the field of the study of biological molecules with the possibility to follow rapid kinetics such as protein folding and unfolding in real time. Second, an imaging end station to study living cells with unique possibility for excitation and detection of unable drugs. The UV microscope allows also biomedical studies such as normal and tumoral tissues as well as plants and biomass studies. Disco Beamline consists of 3 scientists and 1 assistant engineer, and we work with unique academic research group but also with industrial clients. With our academic user, we establish a lot of active collaboration. Indeed, our Beamline staff works every day improving instruments, host users, and also develop research projects, including supervision of master and PhD students. This keeps us up to date with our scientific communities.
On Disco Imaging Station, we use 2 microscope setups. These 2 microscopes are illuminated with the white synchrotron light source, with wavelengths ranging from 190 to 400 nanometers. A monochromator selects the excitation wavelengths to obtain fluorescence images. Attention should be drawn to the fact that the low intensity of this monochromatic light, in the order of few tens of microwatts, limits the beam damage on the sample. This light is also remarkably stable both in time and space. This allows us to perform quantitative imaging of dynamic processes in living cells with the excitations of UV naturally present fluorophore, such as tryptophan, collagen crosslinks, or aromatics. So let's start with the first microscope. This microscope is a wide-field microscope. It was designed to perform fast acquisitions of UV fluorescence images through different emission bandpass filters at high spatial resolution. This setup is typically well suited for following time dynamics of processes with a time step ranging between milliseconds and few hours. For example, with this microscope we can track the accumulation of naturally UV fluorescent antibiotics inside individual bacteria. You can see on this picture that the intensity of the fluorescence increases with time inside each individual bacteria. The kinetics of antibiotic accumulations at the single bacterial level provide key information on multidrug resistance of bacteria, which remains a major challenge for human health. The second microscope is a confocal microscope coupled with spectrometer. With this microscope, we record hyperspectral images using a point scanning technique. On these hyperspectral images, each pixel contains the entire fluorescence emission spectra. This microscope is typically used to track spectral and spatial variations of UV fluorescence in ex vivo samples. For example, this microscope is used to study flax microfibrils. Here, you can see a cross-section of flax stem. On the top, you have all the spectra contained in the image. And when I move the cursor along the image, you can see the spectral evolutions along the different zones of this flax cross-section. From this data, scientists could study how different stresses, like intense period of drought, influence the biochemical compositions of the flax.
Here at the SRCD OCDN station, we use polarized light to probe chiral molecules, mainly for biological and sometimes for chemical samples. Monochromatized light is phase modulated to obtain circular or linear polarized light in the UV spectral band between 360 and 170 nanometers for solubilized samples and down to 120 nanometers for organic films. Radiation damage is avoided using wide sample area of 4x4 millimeters at a low photon flux of 10 to the 11 photons per second. SRCD and OCD are both differential absorption spectroscopies, allowing to probe chiral biomacromolecules such as proteins and polynucleotides. Circular left and right polarized light is absorbed by these chromophores differentially along the spectral band. SRCD lends itself perfectly for secondary structure determination and fold recognition of proteins. A reference database, the PCDDB, and the spectral deconvolution server, BestCell, are available for spectral analysis. For nucleic acids, such as DNA and RNA, a novel database, the NACDDB, is available, allowing for the spectral comparison of polynucleotide foldings. OCD allows to identify, for example, protein insertion into membranes prior to time and money-consuming high-resolution techniques such as solid-state NMR and cryo-EM. Optimized spectral coverage down to the VUV and sample volumes between 2 to 4 microliters make the two end stations very valuable if samples are scarce and precious. Protein and nucleic acids are routinely inspected in various environmental conditions, including pH, salinity, and temperatures. Thermal scans resolve the thermodynamic Gibbs equation following the denaturation and unfolding of macromolecules. During the past decade of operations, many users have obtained valuable information of their mostly complicated samples, whether it be amyloidogenesis or virus proteins. And last but not least, interactions of proteins with nucleic acids and their complexes, which are of interest for epigenetic research nowadays. Soon, we will also provide users with the time-resolved spectral acquisitions ranging from the microseconds to hours for macromolecular dynamic studies.